I guess I could have got a better picture for my thumbnail tonight, but it's been a long day. The picture to my what? The one farthest over, over there, with my finger cut out, trying to get my finger on me. That is a postcard in Las Vegas advertising come to their hotel at the Desert Inn, and you can watch the nuclear bomb testing. That's a postcard you're looking at. And the one on the right, well, I just put that in there because the soldiers were walking through it back in those days. I think that was 54. I'm not sure, or 56 or something like that. The Desert Inn. Isn't that something? Good night, everybody. MSVS, Missing Sky, nice to see you. Love your work so much. And you can find links below to Missing Sky 101. Or just type that into YouTube. Very dedicated. And we destroy what you save, Doug, in HD. And I can't even, because I'm reading on an angle tonight, so I still haven't got the other big screen put up on the wall. I got a little screen here, so it throws me off. But I got a really special night for everybody. I think I do anyway. So let me get this straight. You're gonna go on vacation and watch the bombs fall out. Now, back in those days, and at the same time, you were being inundated with how to build bomb shelters to avoid fallout, and you can protect your family against, fallout, right? Don't bother putting the word nuclear in there. Don't want the enemies to know what you're thinking about. And once again, you're at the Desert Inn. Does that cross your minds? I wonder, gee, honey, we built that, we spent all of our money on the bomb shelter, now we're down at this shitty hotel watching bombs. Do you don't suppose, oh, I don't know, it might come towards. And she says, honey, just go in the room and take your radium suppository and don't worry about it. The government loves you, they got your best interest at heart. They're taking care of everybody but you, is the truth. How's it going? We'll come over to a picture that gave me a lot. Now, are we getting any problems tonight? Let me know with the audio. I'm having huge issues with this audio. I had to dump a whole bunch of stuff today. I imported the GIF files. Ooh, they don't want to do that with Wirecast. Lose his friggin' mind. And just making sure that I'm coming out. I'm gonna tune up a bit. Just watch your volume. Punisher's on me. Good job. Good job, mate. Punisher's making videos. He's out engaging the community. He's engaging his friends and his families. And that's good enough, right? And he's doing it in a nice way. Not that anybody, anyway, is perfect, but I'm just saying we're checking out some of his videos. He's working hard. Tyrion, loving the new studio. Thank you. I'm nowhere near it yet. I'm getting there. We've just been so much heat in the last 4 days. I can't believe I got a stream in any night. It's torture here at around 8 o'clock at night. There's no wind for the last number of days. It's really something. We are on the Sunshine Coast, but this is ridiculous. It's like, anyway, enough about me. What about that polar bear? You wouldn't want that coming after you. Oh my goodness, he coming after me. Wrong way. So unprecedented spike. Let me turn down my headphones. 1501 radioactive atoms, sulfur atoms per meter. That's a lot worse than a radium suppository, I can assure you. Was detected in the California ear. So what's a square meter? What's a square meter? Well, a meter is 3 feet. A fathom is 6 feet, which is usually your length of your tip of your fingers. I know some people, I got 6'1", Dana. I'm only 5'9", Dana. You're lying, it's actually 5'9". So 3 feet by 3 feet by 3 feet, and you get the picture. A cubic meter of air. So you're walking along, do to do, and you're always enveloped in 2 cubic meters of air all around you. You're swinging your arms. Look at me, everybody. I got shiny new shoes. Check it out. Strutting down the road. And now you got 3,002. And the balls you're seeing now, this is caused by spraying salt water on the reactors at Fukushima. And I'll cover that a bit. I'll come back to that later. I want to get into the good stuff, whatever that may be. We don't know tonight. Tonight's one of those nights, a little comical, cataclysmic card game, nuclear war. So I went out and dug up some of the old stuff out of my computers, trying to get everything loaded up into the 2 terabyte. Where I can really go to work on a few out there. Now, you know, people, they see these nuclear testings, say 100 a year back in the 50s and 60s, or say 60s and 70s, whenever it was, I can't even remember anymore. I can open the file up and tell you in a minute, but I'm not going to. We covered all of that in a Nuclear Earth Series 6 of them. I still got one more to do, and we'll do it on this, thank goodness. I knew I was waiting for something to finish that one, because that would be pretty cool. And so when you had 100 tests in America in open air, it floated right across the country. And places like New Mexico were highly contaminated, and Nevada was highly just extraordinary. Highly is a stupid word, really. It's extraordinary contamination, unimaginable. So imagine, you know, the nuclear fallout in Nagasaki and Hiroshima. And so, you know, there was fallout, right? Serious fallout. And a lot of this is fissionable product. If it's exploded on the ground, it bonds with the ground itself. And you can't go in and clean this up. This is fissionable products. That's what happened to John Wayne and about 70 of the cast and crew. They had the natives lying in the Nevada desert, rolling around in radioactive fallout. And people trusted them. They didn't know any better. And then, of course, your loving government, your maniacal, twisted, loving government, who you didn't pay to love you, you paid to do a job, you paid to get out of your life and to do a job so you wouldn't have to get involved. And here you are, you have to get involved. But anyway, so this went on year after year, decade after decade. And they polluted their own country, and at the same time, they were saying, you got to build fallout shelters in case the Ruskies come and get you, right? So you can see how that works. It's pretty twisted. But what exactly do weapons of mass destruction look like? They're nuclear power plants. That's a weapon of mass destruction, and Fukushima has showed us that. In fact, Fukushima is worse than any weapon of mass destruction that we have conceived as children or anybody else on this planet can even conceive. It's going to be successful in killing every species in the Pacific Ocean. And that, of course, all oceans are connected. And a lot of the water tables, if not all of them on the planet, obviously have to be interconnected. The evaporation on the ocean into the upper atmosphere, the upper tropospheres. And I'll bring you up a picture of that. And so this stuff goes up there, and it takes many years for it to rain back down, decades even. And it comes down as radioactive fallout, so you can't escape it. And then so it permeates through your communities, through your local estuaries, through your rivers. And it might look something like this might help. I got to keep my eye over here to make sure. Volume's good now, everyone around. Good stuff. Serious Dana last night. I had to give my voice a rest. Hey, what are you trying to say? You're saying I'm being a slacker last night. I kick your ass. I get your butt. I'll make you drink Fukushima rainwater. You'll be sorry. You'll be crying. We'll see. I'd catch you with my wheelchair. So the waters, they circulate, and there's tens of thousands of miles every day. There's 50 square miles going into the ocean every day. Let me get that out of the way, just because I started and I didn't want to start on that. And I'm going to jump back to some really cool stuff here right away after. And so those buckyballs, those sulfur peroxide elements from spraying salt water on the Fukushima reactors, because it didn't have fresh water, it was 500 miles of coastline destroyed by the tsunami, and it was felt, like you say, in Florida 30 minutes later. That's how powerful it was. And the tsunami went along 500 miles of the coastline. Fukushima just happened to be one of those places. There was 14 reactors went down. But we created, every time we do nuclear testing, we create in the ocean, we created these sulfur peroxide buckyballs. And just a quick understanding of that, what you're seeing there is, I want you to, is like a football or a soccer ball, depending on which country you're in, I guess, is say a soccer ball, which is something we're all, or a tennis ball or whatever, but a soccer ball where you have all these distinct points, and it can ingest, and these are extremely tiny, they're like the dust that floats around your house after you clean your house spotless. And so, and I'm going to go back up to what I had lined up for tonight here in a second, but There's 1,000 gallons going into the ocean every minute, 1,440 minutes in a day, and there's also these buckyballs hemorrhaging into the environment, but from the MOX fuel at the number 3 reactor at Fukushima, and I'll get up to that in a minute for everybody. But let's jump to the next. I want to get some fun out here before I get into that one. Something different. This is a postage stamp, or this is a. I'm sorry. Hang on 1 second. I was supposed to click. There was supposed to be another picture in front of that, so I didn't mess up. And so they're worried about Al-Qaeda today, but years ago they had postcards for the nuclear power plants. Oh yeah, she's down the block there, boy. Go down the shop and get yourself some film. She makes a pretty picture. Now it's like, I'll shoot you. What are you doing with a camera? And I'm going to jump around a lot, man. I got some really interesting stuff imported in. I better take my hand off that because it's rocking. I forgot it does that. I'm sorry, folks. And everything else is fine. Here we go. The Cold War, 1945, 1991. Right, everybody? Just, and then you have stamps for nuclear power going around the planet. And I'm just going to give you a couple of these in a row here. If an A-bomb falls, executive planning, you stick your head in the sand. Or B, you say it's bananas. Or C, you say it's okay, my government would warn me. Any of the above, and you're not very bright. And these guys back in the day weren't, obviously. I must have messed up here tonight because I'm getting my little picture in the background. That's what happens anyway. Let's jump to this picture. Checks and balances, Irina Rell, Mickey Smith, MSVS, Ice 9, NHD, Piano the Precious, Pia, Irina Rell. So, 13P, that was, I can't remember what country that was. That was postage stamps to raise money, electricity. Darn it, I got the name on top of my tongue anyway. But that's Unit 3 behind me, directly behind me. And the crane is grabbing stuff and lifting it up. And it's releasing more gases and radioactive materials into the environment every time it does that. It was reckless. And then you won't see people in there, but you'll, the homeless have been trudged through it all the time to find the hot spots. And when they die, they don't go over in those spots. The Yakuzus and everybody else. And so there's a picture missing in the background, and some of my pictures, so I'm going to show up as a double. The one over my head, right, that one there, that doesn't touch the Unit 4. That's Unit 4 sitting over, but it actually doesn't touch it. But you'll see the trolls out there saying, oh no, it stabilizes the structure. No, it doesn't actually touch it. And in the future, they're going to put a crane in it. Right now, they don't have a crane in it. Unit 4. And so there's no way they can take anything out of Unit 4 because they don't got their crane in it yet. See? And if I wanted to go way down the road with you on that one, who knows? But let's jump back up here to some fun stuff again. Duck and cover. So they were teaching kids to duck and cover for so many years. Now, duck and cover means you're closer to the floor and you're going to suck up the radioactive particles because they like to go to the lowest points. Especially when they get interior, they'll start settling down lower volumes of air. They'll still, like the buckyballs we were talking about earlier, they'll hang around for a long time. We'll talk about it again. Let's see what else we got here in the old folders on my computers. Combination. You can see you're getting a little bit better at marrying photos together. One's a painting, an illustration, and the other one's real life. So does this look like freedom to you? Does this look like, hey, you know, am I okay? Right, you better check me, man. Check me. My God, what's going on? And how many of these kids now are traumatized going through this over and over and over when that happened? And how many will grow up to have some serious side effects? Nobody knows for sure, but I heard and a large percentage. How many of these kids will grow up with leukemias and cancers and autoimmune injuries and deficiencies and defects and birth defects and learning disabilities because they went playing in the water across from the most maniacal thing on the planet from a monster that seems innocuous and benign. All of a sudden, we realize 70 years later, regardless of all the postage stamps, it's actually really truly is evil, much like the crazy above me. You can't get much more wicked than that thing. So National Geographic, International Geographic Congress. How arrogant, International Geographic Congress. See, that's where we became arrogant, when we went in other people's countries that we have no reason to be there for. That without our inflicting our ideologies, they wouldn't have the problems they have. There's a lot of countries definitely about that. A proud reminder, not postage. And you can see that nuclear explosion. Do you think there's not radioactive fallout from all of that? And that it was really bad and that they just lied endlessly. And atomic bombs ends wars and saves many lives. 1945 propaganda. No, it doesn't. It never did and never will. It never can. All it does is it creates more victims, destroys the planet at the same time, and makes some really idiotic people a lot of money. And that even though your university professors and your scientists knows that a banana and a 12-foot fuel rod got nothing to do with it. So take the nuclear, can you be a nuclear scientist? All you got to do is say, yeah, you know, a banana is actually different than a fuel rod. A banana is much more dangerous. If you can do that and say that, you can get a job as a nuclear apologist or as an actual professor or a dean even at a university. All you got to do is be willing to say stuff like that. That is like walking in the sunshine, or that is like eating a potatoes, chips, or that it's like the dental x-ray. Like a dental x-ray is probably the worst out of all of those, but it's like getting a dental x-ray 1,440 minutes in every day for your entire life, 365 days a year. Let's see how many x-rays that works out to be. Where's the x-rays? Oh my goodness. I was clicking, and now life has ran away. I don't even know what I was on. There we go. I'm back on it. Let's bring out good old big feller who really likes an audience. That's probably pixelated. Oh, no, hold it up there. I'll get it to once. Let me see. I'm trying to see myself. There. That's the sweet spot. And so we're talking about 1,440. Double check. Minutes in a day, and then a big old times. Oh, let me see. 365 equals. Oh, yeah, you're getting some serious x-rays there, young fella. You liking that, are you? 525,000. Oh, my goodness, every year. If you're lucky, that's all you're getting. If you only ingested a small amount of Fukushima. Times, and I see cancer takes 5, 10, 15, 20 years to manifest. Lucky you, you'll never understand where it came from. Not that that'll make you feel any better or help liquidating your assets because you didn't listen to what we're saying. Good for you. Now we're going to multiply that times 15 years, say, tops. 15 years, you're going to have tumors because there's so much come true. If you're still eating GMO, you're probably going to get it. Anyway, so 7.8 million x-rays in 15 years. 1,440 minutes a day. That's a pretty big difference than a potato chip. Huh? Yeah? Yeah? That's a pretty big difference than a banana. Well, a banana is homeostasis. And if you eat a banana... Woo! I'm going to cancel here. Hang on. It's trying to shut down on me. Don't click stuff, Dana. Just going to get yourself in trouble. Hey, Roosevelt. Pia, Missing Sky. I want one of those calculators. We'll have a raffle one of these days. You got to send me your banana stories of how you were harassed at the supermarket by bananas, Missing Sky. Let me keep going to something else here. I lost track. Oh, yeah. So 7.8 million x-rays a year. Or 7.8 million over 15 years, you're going to get your tumors. You're going to get your cancers. You're going to have all kinds of issues along the way, because when you ingest the radioactive particles, like the big clouds that came out of Fukushima, And that will continue to rain out because it's continuing to come out. Let me keep going on some of the stuff I got here because I'll digress right quick if I'm not careful. But I want to keep touching back and forth on this stuff. When you blew that up in the ocean, you created these sulfur peroxide, urethol, buckyballs, these tiny spherical shapes that are able to ingest a hot particle. Like even when you cannibalized a building, let me see if I can find something for you. So when you cannibalize these buildings with the detonations, with the meltdowns, it and so everything that falls down on it, they're atoms and particles too, right? A piece of wood is atoms and particles. Your pencil, your mouse is all atoms and particles. And if you cannibalize that, you're releasing all of these atoms and they become ionized and radiated because they went down in the bowels of hell. There's been an internet blackout down there. But you got to think about the detonations at these places. Now, that's Unit 3 and Unit 1. And you can, I'll move out of the way for Unit 1 for a second. But you can see all the big chunks of the building. And Unit 3 was the same thing. It was a different type of detonation. Unit 3 was what we should consider as a nuclear detonation. Not a nuclear explosion, but a nuclear detonation. And they're close to the same. And that was felt, Unit 4 also detonated, rather, and that was felt 25 miles away by an AP reporter. Now just come back and forth here for everybody. Let me run down and cover some headlines, actually. Let's get some ooh-ha-ha going on here tonight. Dirty bombs fears after ISIS sees uranium. Now ISIS is 10,000. It's 10,000 paid for by, you know, Blackwater, the Bilderberg Group and everything else. The people who can't live without conflict. Because if you've got a big weapon manufacturing facility, you ain't going to make any money without a conflict. And because Iraq has already been devastated, why not, right? Well, 80% of the children born in Iraq or in Fallujah are deformed. Women don't want to have babies there. But it's like that all around Iraq. It's not just Fallujah, but that happens to be exceptionally bad because of how much they used there in the battles that they had there with the people they paid to battle them. And I'm not going to go down that road with you, but I mean, Afghanistan, you got 5 million orphans. To get 11,000 Taliban, another 1,000 more than what ISIS got. So is ISIS going to create the justification for another 5,000 orphans? Absolutely. That's how it works. Hamas has 10,000. That was justification for 5 million in refugee camps for 60 years to keep them there. But Iraq has millions missing, millions dead, millions of widows for 11,000 Taliban. You had 28,000 rapes a year in the military, that's reported. 280,000 over a decade to get 11,000 Taliban. You fired 5.5 million rounds a month to get 11,000 Taliban. Do you got any idea how bad of a shot these people actually are? 11,000 people, 5.5 million rounds a month, half of that dirty bombs, they're dirty bombs. Half of those coming out of McAllister's bomb manufacturer, dirty bombs, and they're worried about ISIS getting their hands on uranium. You see how the machine works. But that's what they've done down there year after year for 9 years, 5.5 million rounds a month, and they put out these salacious headlines. And that was a recent headline. I got everything chopped because everything was giving me a hard time tonight. Texas Rangers dispatched to secure the border. Like, can you actually, you know, understand that headline when you think about all the people coming across the border? And the fact that TSA is letting people without IDs fly. Suitcase bombers, anybody? Put a suitcase up your rectum. Breast bombers, you know, all the fearing, right? You know, well, nah, that's okay. Hell with it. Don't worry about it. Al-Qaeda, we pay them. They won't bomb us till we tell them. They won't send the dummies till we tell them, right? But the federal officers have fired their weapons in an altercation at a pro-Israeli. Right, that's because they're brainwashed. They're brainwashed so much they needed to take control because it was Israel and it was okay to do anything extreme because it's Israel. They've been trained by Israelis and that's what they do down there. but there was a blowback. Introducing the iPhone 6, it's going to be made by 10,000 robots, humanoid robots, without the human, well, there'll be some there, but it begins. And of course, DARPA's little pony is going into battle. And so they can strap miniature directed energy weapons on it. They can put nuclear bombs on it, send it in, and blow stuff up. They can use it as suicide bombers, right? And that's what they'll do with it. They'll dress it up like a horse. They'll blow up a vehicle, and they'll say, Al-Qaeda used a horse to blow up the vehicle. And, you know, Israelis eating popcorn on a hill because they were working in the factory making those weapons, making those parts, making those drones, because that's what they do. They're the fourth biggest weapons producer on the planet, or the fourth biggest producer of misery. And Simon Whackjob, who only exists because the media won't shut up and leave him alone, he'd disappear real fast. There's nothing enticing about him. There's nothing cool about him. There's nothing sexy about him. Everything about him is engineered just to be salacious, like a tabloid. He's just a tabloid. And he's going out with a dingbat, just a total bootlicker for the military-industrial complex. Give him 100,000. Come on, put your name to it. You want to be my little snuggy buggy. I'm a pig, but you love me, right, because you're a pig. Yeah, you know it. Israeli jets destroying the Gaza water and sewage system again. Gotta like it. Won't leave it alone. Hey, you think about Israel. They won't admit they got nukes, but they had nuclear stamps. What do you think of that one? That's priceless. And last one on that one was Tel Aviv residents living normally amid the rockets. That's a great read. You should read it. In Tel Aviv, Israel, a week after fighting broke out between Israel forces and Hamas. What fighting? Hamas. 600 of Hamas's rockets are not equal to a single tank round from Israel's 4,400 tanks or their 1,200 airstrikes, all depleted uranium rounds. Depleted uranium. Twisted, demented, stupid, insignificant, mass murdering monkeys, freedom. Ginger induces leukemia cell suicide. Think about that one. How cool is that? Gonna get me some more ginger. Just fooling around, folks. Well, ginger is another one in the big keep of it. That's out there today. And what I'm going to try to do now is when I'm grabbing all this stuff today and every day, instead of just throwing it into the black hole on my computer for some future, hopefully, moment, I can import it and put up 10, 12 headlines, get back on track. But that's a good one. Think about turmeric. It's been used. Think about dandelion root tea. Check that up. That's some CBC. There's some really good studies showing that that can kill cancer. Think about the DCA links below my site. And like I said, I got to get a cancer video together really quick now. I haven't stopped. The heat is too much. I got myself tortured, but it's coming together, so we're still at it. Here's a funny one. I know you're saying, that's cool, Dana. Thank you for that. Tree new J.P. Morgan IT debts include alleged murder-suicide. But there's something a little odd about this one I want you to read. J.P. Morgan has $180 billion life insurance in force on its current and former workers. $180 billion. Life insurance. So if they kill them, they collect. They kill them, they collect. Even when they die, they collect. Even if they quit and die, they collect. See, that's why corporations are not supposed to have human rights. That's why corporations are supposed to have a charter. None of that would exist. Lobbyists wouldn't exist if corporations went back to charters. And that's all because of corporate personhood. Just quickly, was an amendment to the slavery laws, which was meant to free slaves from an oppressive government, is being used by corporations to corporate lawyers. Corporate lawyers had manipulated that law in increments over decades to give corporations human rights. And so, like Justice Hugo Black wrote Eloquent Dissent in 1939, I think it was, how absurd it was that an amendment meant to free slaves from a tyrannical government was being used by corporations to enslave a sovereign people. And you should really look up those words and think about what I'm saying and the significance taking away the corporate personhood, which is an illegal amendment to the Constitution. It's an illegal amendment to the Constitution. The reason that all the corporations in all the democratic countries are getting away with what they're doing is because of corporate personhood. And corporate personhood allows them to profit off your debt if you work for them. Or even if they fine you, you deliver a newspaper and you got your name, they'll take life insurance out on you. You can do it to them, right? So if you were to take money, insurance out on all of J.P. Morgan's executives, you get a payback really soon, I can assure you. It's okay to get your money back from these monsters like that. And I must have screwed up headlines along the way. Hang on. Why? Oh, yeah. Here's one more headline. I'll jump back to the Fukushima. But this is really important. GCHQ, they're like the NSA of America, except they're Britain. And dark arts, now I've always equated that terminology with the assassination and the suiciding squads that go out to bury stuff, and they suicide people and make it look like a suicide. And then they, if the coroner or the police were involved and get suspicious, they walk in and say, hey, diplomatic immunity, we're a big shot, inbreed, mongrelized children of the elite, and we got a diplomatic get-out-of-jail-free card, and we will make your life miserable if you don't shut up. Well, these people have programs, and I want to share some of that with you. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, Earwolf, the third dot down, is Earwolf. These are all programs that they're using and disseminating among intelligent communities and governments around the world now, that have probably been out there a long time, much more sophisticated, is probably on the way once this blows over. And it will, because people will go back to sleep, but I won't. Earwolf, YouTube, it spoofs YouTube comments, profiles, and video collections. Now, you go down to Bombay, the capacity to increase rankings and website traffic. Then you go down further, which that was about right in the middle, Bombay. And if you go down further, let me see. I smurfed up. I can't read from here. So anyway, you can take over YouTube. You can deny YouTube. You can deny me. They can deny me. If someone takes that software and puts it on me, they can deny everything. They can stop you from commenting. They can stop you from seeing me. Stop me from seeing you. Stop everybody from seeing each other. Give you fake websites where you think you're talking to me. And so these live streams at 8 Pacific, British Columbia time, Canada, I think becomes very relevant from here on out. Because you know that's Dana. You know it's me. You know that I run for an hour if I can shut my mouth at the end of the hour. And I catch that, I might go an extra few minutes. But you know that I reliably starts up, and that I'm not typing your message, hi, how are you? That I'm showing up, and I see your comment, and I'll respond to it. That's the good old Dana everybody knows, right? And so in the near future, that's about the only thing you've got to be able to trust on the internet is the live streamers who you're familiar with. Hopefully, they can spoof me, probably, who knows. I think I got one of those voices they're going to have a rough one with. The computer's going to go like, hey, no, I can't handle that. You got to get me used to another couple of thousand first. So there's all kinds of these things. I left it there for you to read through it a little bit later. And you read that top one here. It says, the list data from 2012 says that most of the tools are fully operational, tested, and reliable. And adds, don't treat this like a catalog, because there's only a tiny section of what they can do. If you don't see it here, it doesn't mean we can't build it. And so if you're a child, works for these total monsters, these idiots, these inbreed, mongrelized, disgusting, you know, we look back on history, we look back, we'll think about these people and what they've done for dollars, disgusting, just as disgusting as nuclear scientist, who knows just as well as I do and you do that a banana is homeostasis. You eat it, you off gas the same amount. A fuel rod, you eat it, you drop dead, your organs melt, No one knows what to do with you because you're radioactive. And if you live for a few days, your poop and pee, everything is radioactive, and that can't be good. And so it doesn't mean we can't build it. So let's go back to the other crap that they concocted up 40, 50, 60 years ago to light our way up to the point we are now. Fire and blast! Remember how you used to go into the theaters way back in the day? And they would give you the latest war news, or you would get it on the BBC radio. I didn't import that tonight because that's okay. I got it for another one. Because things haven't changed, right? You think about the top five corporations out there, Disney, Viacom, CBS, ABC, and I can't remember who the other one was. Fox News Corp, is it? Yeah. So those five control 96%. You can go look it up. They really do. Of almost everything that's fed to you, what's considered mainstream media, what's considered mainstream blogs or newspapers, and what's considered mainstream magazines, that's your boy, right? And that's just a handful of people controlling the narrative. And then the rest of the world, they puke, they fart, and everybody goes, woo, right around the planet at the one time, see? But what's really going on here, because that's not what's really happening. I got you, did I? I got you that time. Well, what's really going on is AP and Reuters comes out with a headline and then mainstream media pukes it out, right? So AP and Reuters are the top of it. That's what you should, you know, if you're going to be angry, because everything else is conjectures and is meant to muddle the water on the original story. So the original story is always going to come out of AP or Reuters, and then they have a distribution network, and so it goes out to 1,500. And then all the blogs that are licking their boots all the time pick it up. And this is all done by robots and websites. And so everybody on the planet all of a sudden in all the countries can have the same pictures and the same headlines at the same time. And that's known as Mass MK Ultra. And they're going to set it all off in the near future. Once again, just a quick blurb on that. And I'm sure the comments section covered it good. I got me lucky charm again tonight. I haven't got to it yet tonight. We're going to finish it in a couple of days. It's just too much heat to get anything done here. I only load this up for a stream. And then I got to get out of here. It's too hot for me. It's really something. I've never seen it like this here. We're on the Sunshine Coast. But anyway, the planes flying through the nuclear test. It's not just that testing going over some communities for a couple of thousand miles in America and Canada and United and in Mexico and all around the world into the Pacific and into your drinking water. And then they lie about it. And they're making all these documentaries, duck and cover, teaching the children. Don't worry, we're here to protect you. The government got your best interests at heart. And they're detonating 100 a year. And the fallout's going through all these communities. This is the sickest thing imaginable. This is the most maniacal thing even conceivable, what they done then. But they continue to do. They buried it and hid it on purpose. They know that there's a huge difference between a banana and a 12-foot nuclear fuel rod of uranium-238 and plutonium. They actually know the difference. And they lie to you and they say, no, no, it's like a banana. So here's an old-fashioned Geiger counter. Safe, exciting, instructive prospect for uranium so they can build more. They left 500 abandoned mines in Navajo Native countries just to murder them, just to kill them, just hateful. But the future generation is coming at them, and they know it, and we're taking them down. We're going to just send all of our children there to die, right? And eventually we'll plug up the hole. That's what they're doing at Fukushima. That's a picture of Fukushima. And they got the homeless women there, and they're breeding babies like crazy, and they're genetically modifying them. And they crawl up, and they crawl down there, and they sacrifice to the nuclear gods. Oh, come, all you grateful, and save the world by sacrificing. Nothing has changed. Everything is the same. See, what you're seeing here is the bellies of the beast. They're releasing 120,000 liters in the spent fuel pools from all the rods that were used in the chain reaction. And so those pools boil off and they go up these stacks and they go up higher and they don't come right back down to that little community in the background right away. But of course they do, because it's doing that The fuel pools boil off 120,000 liters a day, the spent fuel pools. Let me run that by you one more time, because I'm not sure if you understand the significance of what I'm saying to you. The fuel pool boils off 120,000 liters a day forever in your capacity. And those radioactive isotopes from the microfracking fractures on the fuel rods, because as soon as they go in the chain reaction, they fracture because they get so hot. And they have all these microfractures. And the cesium can spill out, see? And so they're always releasing, and these are the parts of the noble gases. And so that you can't contain, put these in what's actually a dry sarcophagus because it'll blow up. So a dry sarcophagus means the concoction is cooled down enough that they're just going to let it vent into the environment. And so 10, 15, 20 years down the road, everybody in that environment is going to have to get cancers, and they're going to have to marginalize them. And the GHQ and the NSA and, you know, their partners with Twitter and Facebook and YouTube built this to keep control of it and then use it to find the subversive and then try to control that in a temporary, but in the long term, be able to control them psychologically with patterns on your screens to send your messages, control who you get to see. But all nuclear plants leak into your ocean. Look how this thing is right on the ocean, and it boils a million gallons a reactor per minute. So each glass of water has got 7,500 to 100 million, excuse me, and phytoplankton. They make the oxygen, and they're the basis of the food chain in the ocean. And so this thing boils a million gallons. Right, there's four glasses in a liter. You know, keep doing the math. It's a lot. And so they're killing creatures at an enormous rate. But you go down to the beach and flip over a rock, and they'll tase you, pepper spray you, bankrupt you in court, vilify you in the media as environmentally a monster. And you teach people to come in and attack people on the beaches that way. But yet they destroy the ocean. They destroy rivers. They destroy everything with boiling a million gallons a minute. You have to really take that into consideration of how many creatures is in a glass of salt water. Just a glass. To 75 to 100 million phytoplankton. How many other creatures are in that glass? Billions, see? What gave them the right to destroy all of that and vilify us for a tin can or littering, or vilify us for spitting, or vilify us for stepping into a beach where they sanitized the entire coastline and made it radioactive anyway? They just want to keep you away from it because it's all radioactive. So the AP and Reuters disseminate it, and then everybody else regurgitates it, and everybody else is just vying for a Twitter account, a Facebook account, you know, and becoming a personality. And their job is to sell it, no matter what it is, no matter how disgusting it is. If they got Dick Cheney there, they smile, put on the face because they want him to come back. And if they screw that up, they piss off Dick Cheney, they'll get their asses fired. And so they're not allowed that. Everything is scripted. They sit there, all the media sits there, and they go through everything they're going to, like, the show, so there's no accidents. And then they do the live show. So they do the whole show a couple of times where everybody knows their place. And then everybody's told what to say to be salacious as a pundit. If you do that for 5 or 10 years, we might get you more time. But that's enough fame because you're actually a degenerate. And we got to introduce degenerates like you into the media stream slowly. Because there's only five controls the media. And that's what all we're up against. We can destroy them. We will, right? So that's all the, like, that, they destroy nothing but land, the nuclear industry. That's an amazing chunk of land, you see, they got destroyed there. This is an amazing chunk. Just duck and cover. You get closer to the ground, and you, instead of going in a shelter, this routine of ducking and cover and fear is what I meant to say, I'm sorry. And fear, and just keep the fear going, and nothing has changed. Iran's got 49 bases around it. What is it going to do? How is it going to get out of there? 49 bases. And they're stuck there. Anybody wants to retaliate against, if America or Israel wants to retaliate, they got 49 bases there. They can make something up. They blow up a city in America, They blame it on Iran, and they hit it with 49 bases, and 10 years later, it's still falling out of the sky, and there's nobody left, only mongrels and savages. If that's what you want, that's what you're going to get, I can assure you. Because Fukushima, not counting everything else on this planet, is a friggin' nightmare of just unimaginable proportions. It's man-made elements that don't exist in our solar system. Let me bring up some new stuff. Here's a good one for you. You're going to like that one. Radioactive toothpaste. Yay. So it can happen here, so let's nuke them first. Right? The propaganda is still going on today with Israel and Iran. You know, 7,500 lobbyists trying to get a nuclear war using nuclear weapons as depleted uranium munitions. And I got quite a bit of that stuff, you know, way back in the day. But it can't happen here. They were doing it every year, like 100 nuclear tests in their own country. And what they were saying could happen was happening every year 100 times. Every 3.5 days, they were setting off a nuclear weapon average for a decade in America and fallout across the country. And that's why there's so many cancers, so many Alzheimer's, so many diabetes, so many of these autoimmune deficiencies, so many tragedies, so many displaced and people that can't function, because not only the GMO over the last 3 decades have infiltrated every aspect of everybody's life, in all our schools, all our lunchrooms, all our cafeterias, all our children's. They're here to protect the children, and instead they're feeding them GMO. They don't even try. And they're the teachers, they're the institutions. They turn their back on us. All of our teachers in our schools have turned their backs on us. And yes, I know they're on their loads, but because they shouldn't be in the job in the first place. They're only picked because they were weak. That's why they got picked for the job, and they can spit out and regurgitate insignificant propaganda to indoctrinate a willing, you know, a public that trusted them, that was led to believe you can trust your government. You can't trust your government under any circumstances. They're here watching me right now so they can have a paycheck in the hopes they can get a pension, in the hopes they can steal more from it. All they got to do is lie to themselves. And everything I'm saying is not significant and not real, like they've been doing since the beginning of this whole thing. Radioactive toothpaste, radioactive everything, the whole country. They go in, they test the winds. You can see the whole, what they've done was, that's fallout, you know, they turned it into a beautiful thing, but it's fallout right across the country. It's just fallout right across North America. And not only do it to their own, but they're doing it to everybody else for a paycheck. Because they believe the lie so much. Your professors, they don't believe the lie. They know that a banana got nothing to do with a 12-foot fuel rod. They know potato chips got nothing to do with man-made ionized radioactive material. Our media won't fact-check it. Our media won't hold them accountable. Our media can't and won't challenge them, because they won't come back and they won't have a job. What are we going to do? We can't trust our media anymore. That's the problem. And corporate personhood, if we can't solve that, we're hopeless. And so that's why I'm here. That's why I'm back. That's why I'm at it twice as much. That's why I do. That's why I work so friggin' hard just to pull off this little tiny thing that I'm doing, to the point where I don't know if I can do that anymore. I can't keep doing this. I just can't keep doing it. But now that I find out about the GCHQ, able to manipulate anything, where, you know, I have this epiphany this afternoon that my live stream is the only thing I can trust. At least I tried. I done the best I could. That's all I can do, right? And that's what I do every day. That's what I do for years. That's what I am. I'm a researcher, but I've taken it to a new level because of the urgency of what, you know, we have discovered. Because it was a shock to me to learn that a banana got nothing to do with a 12-foot fuel rod. And that they're not the same, even though it looks the same to me. I can't really tell the difference. But now I studied a lot, and I found out that a banana, because it's actually only this big, and a 12-foot fuel rod is 12 feet. And so I don't know why I never saw that. That should have been pretty obvious. And a banana is yellow. I should have seen that. And the other one is not. Right? But everybody else fell for it too. Right? All the BBC, New York Times, everybody out there fell for that one for 70 years, right? But all of a sudden, the last couple of months, everybody's kind of waking up. And I was like, you know what? I think there's a difference. That was like, see, I still don't believe there was a radiation release at the WIP repository at Carlsbad, New Mexico. So, you know, on February the 6th, when they had a truck fire, I think trucks are dangerous. So dangerous, that's why they couldn't go back down in the mine for 9 days. And then they said, hey, we got a radiation release, but it had nothing to do with a truck fire, but it was actually a truck fire, right? And so that would make sense, because why else wouldn't people go back down in the WIP repository in New Mexico for 9 days if a truck fire wasn't actually dangerous, right? And so nuke is code word for trucks, I think. And I think Chevy and Dodge, they're the actual monsters that they're making the trucks. And everybody works around that. It's like some kind of Twilight Zone movie. And that's just the way it is. And there's nothing we can do about it. I'm starting to ramble now. But, like, you know, we're going to see, you know, if the Americans want to go to war against us, they don't, because Canada actually have big cannons where we have these $80,000, $90,000 trucks stuffed down into wheel fire cannons with trucks at them. And then America is screwed. And so they won't mess with the Canadians because we're not afraid. The light went up and sent it across the border. Trust me, your defense, one defense against fallout, is not to piss off the Canadians, because we got a lot of trucks. We've been storing them here, stashing them away at our repositories for just a time. When everybody says, ah, there's a Canadian, we don't have to worry about it. What's this? They got trucks. Nobody said anything about trucks. We surrender. So the Americans for many decades were saying, you know, you got to build a fallout shelter. You got to build a fallout shelter because fallout is coming to get you. They're going to get you. It's wicked. Wait now. Surely I got a picture there somewhere. A fallout, Dana. Are you getting slack? Where's your pictures? I had a long day. Give me a break. I was at this all day. I don't know what I'm doing sometimes. I just managed to get on here every night at the last second. So when they're testing in their countries, and they've done an amazing amount of that, am I missing something? Is that not fallout? Is that not fallout? Did I miss something here? Right? Is that not the same as fallout? At the same time they got fallout, they're saying your one defense against the Ruskies dropping a big nuclear weapon is to build a fallout and you'll be okay. And your government didn't hold anybody accountable. Your government won't even fire somebody. That's not a government. That's a dictatorship. That's a creature that is totally out of control. Like Hanford. You know, 500 miles of drums. 500 miles of drums at Hanford. Just down the road from me. Your government is insane. 450 billion gallons dumped directly into the soil of radioactive waste. These drums are rotten. You have to build technology to deal with it. You just can't let this continue. Right by the rivers, right by the Columbia River. It's shocking what's really going on. The truth of it is, they're saying, oh, you know, you got to how to protect yourself, you got to build a community bunker. And at the same time, they were dropping bombs a few hundred miles away themselves, and that was falling out where they were out in the garden digging the bunkers. And these people died, and their children died. And the media never reported on it. People just dropped dead back in them days. And these are just wicked, disgusting people that are still alive now that was doing that, still in our governments now, still in control right now, and they knew they lied, they knew they continued to lie, and they'll lie till they die because it'll all come back and get them, won't it? But, like, you know, I was thinking that I might have to give it up and just do mini documentaries because I can't keep up with what I'm doing. I can't sustain what I'm doing, that's for sure. I'm trying. I can do things that I'll keep doing what I'm doing. I'll keep researching like I'm doing, but I don't know if I can sustain it. Right? It's overpower, it's overload. And my brain can only, you know, I torture myself to death sometimes with the stuff I read and the stuff I watch and the stuff I got no choice but because once I see it, I have to understand it. And just the human testing and the animal testing has really taken its toll. Like, that's mad. How can you, like, Dr. Raymond Gilmedy, he just burnt up beagle dogs and beagle puppies. He murdered them. He watched them suffer with cancers, and then he tortured them to death by giving them cancers. He's done that for 30 years with no regret for an industry that he knows that everything he made in Hale of Loveless and New Mexico laboratories, Dr. Raymond Gilmedy, he killed beagles for 30 years, but other laboratories done the exact same tests for peer review studies at other institutions. And it's not just beagles, though, see? It's every creature out there. And he went home and told her families, they probably had a pet dog there, and they told her family, always feeding them, pretending. They were pretending the whole time. True monsters in our midst, true goblins in our neighborhoods, true creatures in our power structure, true nightmares to the creatures that they come in contact with. They're death camps of the most hideous. Yet they come, and if you left your dog in a car, I can understand the dog is stressed and everything else like that. But they get vilified to the point where this is people, you got people that are innocently caught up who truly made a mistake or truly got caught up in something. And it's come to the point now where everybody is just jumping on everybody for everything. Because to hide what they done, they created this animosity, this environment, where normally you would break the window and you tell buddy off, he wouldn't do it again because he had to pay for a window. And if he didn't shut his mouth, you call the cops. But if he understood and he said, I'm glad you broke the window, what was the harm, right? Thank you so much for breaking the window. What would be the harm in doing that? Standing up and saying, oh, I'm not going to get involved. I can assure you when I was growing up, he got involved. Some guy was beating up his wife down the road. We went down and beat the shit out of him on a dark and rainy night and made sure he didn't do it again. And if he did, they had a shovel and there was a hole in the woods for him. That's a fact. You say, I got a gun and a shovel, buddy, and we'll come back. And you won't be found, I can guarantee you. We'll plant blueberry bushes and we'll celebrate your miserable existence is now gone. That's how it was done. You go back down and where I come from, they ask you where to get the berries. You got to go up, tell you to see the stone where they killed the old robber. And you go left after that, and you go up there and you'll see a little grave to the right where they had to kill some more robbers. And they left their graves there on the side of the road on purpose to teach the rest of them that you didn't do it to them. And that's how it used to be done. I can tell you the story, right, where the whole community went down and they shot them all, and as they ran out of the house, as they burnt it down, and they threw their bodies back down into the fires and killed everything there because they were robbing the community, beating everybody up, stealing from everybody. And when the cops came there, this is a true story, Newfoundland. When the cops came out and said, who done it? 400 of them said, we did, in one voice. They walked away and went back to St. John's in the story. Community killed them because they were bad people. But they didn't have any more problems with anybody else in that community. They only done it because the police didn't do their job and they couldn't take the raping, the murdering, and the thieving anymore. But now we take it. Now we sit there and bootlick like it's okay. Oprah will tell us what to do. CNN will give us a good conjecture. Fox will give us some commentary. MSNBC will tell us why we got to kill them because they make the weapons. No such thing as a safe radiation, so why are they dumping it into the open pits? They know it's going to break open. They know it's going to contaminate the groundwater. It's supposed to be, they told you it was going to be in the sarcophagus. They told you they were going to deal with it. They told you we need all that money every year because we're doing our job. What they forgot to tell you was they never, ever, not a single time, ever done their job. And what they didn't throw there, they put in the weapons. 20 train car loads a day coming out of McAllister bomb manufacturer in Oklahoma. And then the soldiers come back and have deformed children because they're contaminated because of the blowback from the high explosives. Because it goes through the air and catches fire. They go over inspected, they become radiated from the uranium-238. It's not tipped, it's not coated. It destroys everything forever. It contaminates the land, the soil. It poisons all the children in the countries. It's dirty bombs. Dirty bombs, but you're worried about the dirty bombs that might find their way in because security and Mexico nuclear threat. Where's it to? Recent headline. Dirty bombs fears after ISIS sees uranium. But yet they fire two million at least dirty bombs in Iraq and Afghanistan like that every month. That's record. That's government records. That's McAllister. They got four bomb. McAllister just happens to be the big one. There's four of them. Now all you do is make depleted uranium, dirty bombs, rounds. What do you think Prince Harry fires in the back of that helicopter? They're all dirty bombs. It's the sickest thing imaginable. He served his time with the military, but you never heard this narrative, because you won't hear David Icke. You won't get Jeff Rins putting me up there like with this stuff. They don't want me out there. You won't get Red Ice Creation shoving me out there. You're not going to get activist posts putting me out there. You won't get InfoWars putting me out there. And that's not going to happen. I make them look like they eat dirt all the time. All of a sudden, they got to do a reel. They got to talk about real issues. I'm not going to show up out there. No matter what. No one's going to give me a boost. I have to do it the hard way. That's the way I like it. I'd rather that way so I can spit on these friggers later for being bootlickers, for sucking up to the machine, for being naive, for not even checking it out, not even doing their own researching. They claim they do, but I've went in and bullied them many times and say, hey, go check the links, and they remove my comments to the point now I got so many in my collections of them doing that to me. There's nothing left in that I can think about, only that they know better, or they're the stupidest people imaginable. That's hard to believe when they play so many games for so long now. You know the jet stream is real, right? Yeah, do you realize that the jet stream is actually real? I know this is a phenomenon for the people that like to bully on me and Martin, all these death threats I get. You gotta realize I got 1,000 videos. I've been at this for many years, researching and sharing the information, because it's just cool sometimes, you know, to do that. And I've been doing it for so long, I do more of it. But the jet streams come from Japan in 3 days or less. At 100 miles an hour, that's 2,400 miles. It never stopped leaking out of Fukushima. It never stopped leaking out of there. It's still leaking out of Fukushima. It's still hemorrhaging out of there. And we get the little mouthpieces in the media out there mention some, and then they lift their nose up at us. And they won't carry the truth. They just carry these idiotic idiots and let them get away with it. And they don't call them out. They don't do what we do. They don't do what I do. They don't say, hey, Ken Buesler, a banana actually got nothing to do with a 12-foot fuel rod. You're a lying sack of shit. They won't say, hey, you know, that a potato chip got to do with it. They won't open their mouth and get into the fray. They don't want to be, you know, afraid they want to do an interview with these people later. They don't want to alienate themselves. I don't think of it that way. I don't care that I'm alienated from all of these people. That's not what I do. I'm not doing what I'm doing because I want to be doing what I'm this. You think I want to do this? You think I want this monkey on my back? Knowing what I know? Seeing, you know, just... It's just the entire litany of the nuclear industry, and come to the realization that all of our professors and all of our deans, all of our academics in the nuclear industry know that a banana's got nothing to do with a 12-foot... chain reaction, ionized radiated fuel rod. That's so disappointing. That's so frightening that so many people bought into that. And that they don't understand that it's not too late to flip it. You know, they got to flip. I don't know what to do. I need 10 people. I need 850 scientists. I need a 300-foot boat with a submarine like Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution. And don't think for a second I don't think about that every friggin' day. Every hour of the day that I got to get to the point where I can have that, or nothing will ever happen. I can't trust a friggin' soul in out there. I have to go check it myself. I got to go do everything myself. And how the hell can I do that? That's ludicrous to even consider it. But yet that's how I think every day. That's how I wake up and go to bed every night. Then what am I going to do? I don't have 850 scientists at my disposal. I don't have 100-foot boats and the budgets behind that. I don't have the millions necessary. I have the ability to do this, but they're not going to give me it up. They're not going to say, hey, Dana, you know, we're going to help, right? We're going to give you a real heads up, real hands out, a real ability to go do it yourself without no without no interference. No, they don't want independence out there, right? They don't want people that know it, flushed it out, and are able to come out and challenge their narrative. They want their narrative to be that Unit 4 is okay, and that everything will be good. You just got to trust the homeless at Fukushima. It was just a detonation, and fuel rods went everywhere. Yeah, Ken Buesler's not going to go down there and try to help them. Yeah, it's nothing to worry about. We took care of it like we do with all the nuclear waste. We dump it in the ocean, put the money in our pocket, say we need more money to keep it nice and safe. Well, it's up floating around in our upper atmosphere and our troposphere, and it's going into our ocean at a million or at a 1,000 gallons a minute, 1,000 pounds a minute. Think of 1,000 pounds of the St. Paddy's Day dye every minute, 1,440 minutes. 750,000 St. Paddy's Day a year radioactive material. I want you to realize that the ocean is not infinity, and that what happens is that it comes over and it washes down to the coastline from the rain out. It's coming over and slamming into the coastlines in 130 days at 2 miles an hour, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for 131 days. It's on your coastline, but it never stopped coming out of there. It just never stopped coming out of there. Every minute, what you see here is what's coming out of there, at least, if not 10 times more. But at least that much of radioactive water, hot, fissionable, running over hot, fissionable products, extraordinary, splitting the atoms, creating the ionized elements, the ionized isotopes, the ionized particles, like infinity. It's a perpetual motion misery machine that's coming out of there. And that what you got to realize is that that ocean at 130 days is filled up. At 130 days, it's now radiated from one end to the other end because the plume never stopped coming out. So the first day, 130 days later, the plume got there, but behind it was 129 plumes. That's why I'm always trying to get that, but it's so easier to do with this platform, to put that message into your head. It's 50 square miles a day, right? The Japanese have done the studies that they found the plumes, and I've covered so many times. What they call a plume, like a single plume. It's not a single plume, though. It's not, right? It's a plume every minute. Because there's mountains behind it, and where there used to be an old river underneath it. Did you think that river just magically stopped and went away because they built a nuclear power plant that rivers respect borders or something? No, it doesn't work that way. And so my issue is because I spent 14 years as a commercial diver in the ocean. We should be studying every one of these birds. We should be studying all the creatures that live on the shoreline. The first 30 feet of the ocean, and I have equated it many times in my personal life with people, on planes. I've had entire planes flying across Canada to jobs, listening to me, loving me, talking about how much life was underwater, how there was enough just on the Canadian coastline to feed the entire planet in the first 30 feet of water with protein and sustain that. Now, I truly believe that because I spend 14 years, over 300 days a year, 6 hours a day on the ocean floor. I see things a lot different. But I grew up with that, and that's all I thought about all my way, my entire childhood, was that I was going to grow up and that's what I was going to do my entire life, and which is what I've done. The ocean is absolutely stunning. It's stunning underneath there. It's just, there's a couple of million species out there, and we're never going to know. We're going to suffocate the whole friggin' ocean. Because the plume is coming out at a sustained rate, right? It's coming out at 1,000 gallons minimum a minute, 400 tons to 800 tons a day. And then, of course, the first day, if that was just a plume, it would have came over and ran to the American-Canadian coastline at 2 miles an hour, like all the studies have already showed. In 130 days, it would have been smack on the coastline. And every day behind it was another plume. So at 130 days, the ocean was filled, right? In that capacity of what I'm saying. So imagine at 1,200 plus days, how much at 1,440 minutes a day. is going out there, and the urgency, because we're not studying, we study tuna. We study tuna because they eat fish up the food chain, so to speak, but we study all tuna and whatever. It's just nonsense what you're doing to you. Because it comes into your coastline and it gets picked up in rain and washes back down on your shoreline. The first 30 feet of water is a city of life. It's the nursery of the ocean. Right? So all that rain down into the woods that gets liberated back down into the shoreline, because that's what happens. Rain washes down to the coastline. And so when I'm in heavy rainy seasons, there's 26,000 islands up here, I'll look for sandy areas because you don't get that much sediment in the sandy areas. You're looking for rocky areas, and because the forest, 26,000 islands take you 71 years. I've been on about 4,000 of those islands. You can only dive 6 hours a day on the ocean floor. When you're on the ocean 300 days a year, up to 100 days back to back, you got a tendency to try to get off the boat. So you jump on islands and swim to island, swim to another island, and you take some food with you, or you eat food along the way. I always like to have a little barbecue, a cup of tea and stuff like that, and just because it's magical. But now it's all radioactive, and I desperately want to get up there and investigate those islands, but it would take you 71 years to investigate all those islands at one island a day. But they are the nursery for the ocean. The ocean is a soup of life. Not just a glass of water with 75 to 100 million phytoplankton of salt water, but the urgency that I've been trying to, and what I'm trying to do, I think still evades the academic community. For some reason, a banana to them is the same as a 12-foot nuclear fuel rod. I better come over and check the time. And it's an hour and 11 minutes. I'm sorry, folks. Okay, I'll come in right quick just because you've been so patient. And we'll say goodnight. Everybody's probably saying, Dana, an hour is gone. Good night, John. Good night, MSVS. Stacy, we love what you're doing, honey. And all the two Stacy Anderson, too, you know. Of course, I was talking to that time. And Stacy 74. And I just, you do so much work over there. I'm clipping around on people's sites and I download your videos. So when you see, like you got some people just watched a few minutes, I'm sorry because I didn't stay on your site. But I download it, I rip the audio in the background, and then I stick it on my headphones when I'm out the door a lot of the time so I can listen to it on the go. Radioactive Banana, Guy Hills, everybody, Multicom, I'll give it up. MSVS, that's where it's getting close. Tomorrow I'm going to try, if it's not too hot, I'm going to try a live Google stream. So I'll put up a short video, say I'm going to go over to Google. If you want to join in on a conversation, I'll accept it and we can talk. So it's worth staying around for an hour and 11 minutes to catch that one, because talk I can, talk I will, and we'll still do a stream tomorrow night. Amthurst, Checks and Balances, Ronald, thank you, folks. Tinfoil Hatter, Fix It Stupid, Radioactive Banana, Pia, Slipper, Pixel, Stacy Anderson, hugs for you, sweetie. We love what you're doing. It's so hard work. You put the extra in. I see what you're doing. And Missing Sky, Miss Milky, Rad Chick, Kevin Blanche, Thomas Ackerman, all kinds of people. I can't possibly, and I really should include every night all of those at least, and I don't. But I think I am getting back on track with the new software. I'm definitely getting the hang of it. You know, just wouldn't, I put all this in there tonight and I couldn't get it to work. The audio, blah, 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 blah. And I figured out I had a GFI file in there somewhere, found it, got it out, and it worked. And I was like, all day to import all this, try to put it together. Good night, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow night. Piano for Precious, Radioactive Banana, Spirit Winds, everybody else, Original Punisher. Good night, folks.